Once Egypt was known for its great pyramids, powerful pharaohs, and the mighty Sphinx. But now it is tiny in the eyes of men, literally. Egypt is shrinking. Can two scientists, a politician, and a news reporter save Egypt?
So, you all know why we're here, to discuss the fate of Egypt and what to do about it.
Well, we know that Egypt is shrinking, but we don't know why.
The most likely reason is global warming.
Yeah, global warming has obviously dried up the Nile and is stopping the rain from the evaporated river from falling. Therefore, Egypt is shriveling for no apparent reason.
You just gave a reason, dummy.
Okay, we know that why Egypt is shrinking, but we don't know how to stop it.
Simple. All we have to do is pour something really cold on it, making it rain.
Something like dry ice.
You can't pour dry ice.
Okay, really cold water.
Not cold enough.
Liquid nitrogen.
Yes, you're onto it.
Okay, liquid nitrogen it is, but how are we going to get some?
Simple, I can get some from the university. Or from Bok Industrial Gases.
To Bok we go.
Sometime later.
Okay, we've got the liquid nitrogen, but how are we going to get to Africa and find Egypt?
Well, all we have to do is trek through the African jungle until we get to the basic position of Egypt, then wander around in the desert until we find a country about the size of your shoe.
I'll go arrange a boat at once.
After several days at sea, our heroes reach the African jungle. Several more days later, they reach the Sahara Desert.
Guys, there's a crocodile behind us!
Liquid nitrogen!
It's growing!
Our victorious heroes return home to celebrate.
Boys, we have a problem. Egypt hasn't stopped growing.
Boat at once.